Okay, hello and welcome to the next part. So in this part, we will finally start making the first game. So I will make two videos for each game. One is where I go through every step, and the other one will be where I make kind of the highlights. So if you're watching either of them right now, then you can watch the other one by going to the description. Let's call this Pong. So here we have the template project, so let's open the source code file. And let's execute this template file to see where we start. Okay, so we have a black screen. Let's actually make this a little bit more bright. Let's go not 100% black. And now we should have a decent background color. Yeah, that looks pretty good. So next, let's try to make the player. So the player in Pong is a rectangle. Yeah, here we go. So let's try to move this rectangle around. Okay, so here you can see I can move it up and down. And yeah, now we move this rectangle 100 pixels per second, and this will be consistent on every device that we run this program on. And yeah, now we have a nice, again, the nice movement. So let's add the ball. So the ball is a circle, and here we have the ball in the center of the screen. Pretty nice. So let's try to move this ball around. So now it will move to the left at this speed. And what's nice with this velocity, we can later on do the collisions, the bouncing. By simply reversing the sign of one of these values, we can change the direction it's going. So yeah, let's just exactly do that. And now it should bounce off the left wall. Yeah, and it did. So, and there was a weird thing going on where it was a bit stuck in this left wall. Okay, so now let's also do the right side of the screen and the bottom side. So now this ball should forever be going inside this screen here. So we can make a very little box here. Yeah, so now we have a little box where we can play with this ball. So now we have the collision happening exactly when the correct side hits the wall. So now it looks very smooth. Kind of oddly satisfying how it bounces through all these corners. But that was kind of fun. Anyways, so let's try to make the collision happen with the rectangle. We start by checking if the ball is inside this area here. So now we should be able to see. Okay, here we go. So if the circle is anywhere else, it's white. And when it gets into this range here, it's blue. So that works pretty good. Okay, so the next step, let's check if the ball is inside this area here. So now we are looking at the x values. Okay, so now it's blue, it's white. And let's see if we can get a red here. Yeah, it was a red when it crossed this plane here. And if it's inside the rectangle, it should be purple. Okay, let's actually make the rectangle a bit wider. But yeah, this is working pretty well. So, how can we make a collision now? Well, the idea is if it's purple, so if both values are true, we want to flip the velocity. Now the question is, which velocity value do we flip? And the whole idea now is, we simply check what color, so which Boolean state was enabled before it entered the square, or the rectangle later. And yeah, here we again go with this weird bug, where it's stuck in the wall sometimes. And again, the reason is that sometimes one frame goes further in and another frame goes less out. So you can repetition. You can get a nice repetition. And here you really well was able to see how the frames sort of increased and decreased in time. And it moved a little bit to the left even. So we have to also add the cooldown. Okay, pretty nice. It bounces off the side here. And we don't get the bug where we are stuck. Pretty nice. So this works. Let's also check if it works for this bottom side here. And that didn't really work. So interesting. Okay, so let's see. So now we should have a better. Okay, it was still kind of stuck here in the wall. Yeah, I believe it works. I'm just moving as fast as this ball is trying to bounce away. Okay, so we have to actually make the ball move a little bit faster. This way I'm not able to catch up so quickly. Yeah, I think that's fine. So now I should be able to get the ball behind the player. Ah, okay. Yeah, now maybe we get this awesome behind the player bouncing effect. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so of course this will not happen in the pong game, because the left wall will be where the player scores, right? But this is still pretty fun to look at. And now I think the collision cooldown is at a good value. So next, one last thing for the collision. Let's actually make the ball collide when the circle is in the corner and not the center. Yeah, it bounces exactly at the correct time here. Yeah, that looks very smooth. It looks like it bounces exactly how it should. Yeah, I like this a lot. And we can just play with the ball. That's so funny. Okay, I'm having way too much fun with this. So anyways, let's get back to Pong. Yeah, now we have the nice rectangle, we have the white ball, and we can just bounce the ball off the rectangle. And now we should have a little bit more randomness here. When I hit the ball, I should be able to change the direction a bit more. But as you can see, we get some different angles each time. So we get a nice, it's not very, we don't get too much repetition going on. Okay, so I believe the next step is to add the opponent. Here we have the opponent, and right now he's not doing a lot. Okay, let's add the movement to the opponent. And yeah, there we go. So, and he's doing a good job at that. Looks very AI like. So let's see. Maybe now it should. Okay, that looks good. Yeah, now we have Pong. So this is at this point, it's basically just polishing the feeling. So one thing that we could do is we could disallow the player to go outside of the screen. I think that's a nice first start. So let's implement that. Okay, yeah, so now I can't move out of this boundary, and the opponent also can't. So let's also, oh yeah, and he was too slow. So that's nice. Let's actually make the score system. So let's see if the ball resets whenever it goes to one of the walls. So I will just fail this catch, and yeah, it reset it to the center. So my opponent scored 1 point. So now it should correctly display whenever there's a score happening. Okay, my opponent got 1 score. Pretty good. Is this now exactly the same distance? It looks pretty good to me. Yeah, let's multiply it by 10 every time we get a score. Yeah, so now it's 10 and it's still aligned perfectly. So that looks pretty good. And yeah, here's the center line. One thing I want to definitely add is a way that the ball, you know, when it respawns in the center, that we have a little bit of a break so we can react to it. It was stuck for a second here, for half a second. So let's see this again. Okay, that looks pretty good. Maybe we can make a nice transition here. Looks pretty good. And let's also randomize the velocity when it enters the screen. Random velocity here. Okay. So let's actually, over time, we might want to increase the speed of the ball very slightly. Let's see if it goes faster. Okay, yeah, so it's definitely going faster. But I noticed that when looking at the output, the velocity, the y value, actually is not getting randomized. So I believe I did it in the wrong branch. And yeah, just I'm losing to the opponent. He's way too strong. And now the y value is getting randomized whenever it hits the rectangle of the player. So yeah, now right now it's pretty straight, but it should get randomized into something else. Let's see. Yeah, now it's going up. So yeah, this is working. And yeah, I had no chance there, it was too fast. But that's pretty intense. Yeah, I have no chance. Okay, now you could polish more on the gameplay side. You could add a difficulty mode and stuff like that. And I believe I will just add one more thing. And that is I want to make a menu. Pretty nice. We got the play and the exit. Let's actually make them bigger. So now we just check if we are hovering about these buttons. And if we click, we terminate whatever it should do. And let's see if we can click these buttons. So, but first we should... Okay. Yeah, this is pretty intense. So that's not good. So yeah, now we get a nice button effect. So let's see. Let's try to try to click on exit. And nice. And let's now try to click on play. And we get to the Pong state. Pretty good. Yeah, let's add to Pong if we press escape that we get back to the menu. So let's play. Let's lose 1 point so we can escape. And everything is resetted again. Kind of one thing that would be cool is if in the menu state here there was a Pong game by two AIs, right? Okay, so I believe it's nice if we make them darker so they are not so visible, and also that they are drawn behind the play and the exit. Yeah, I kind of like that. Looks pretty good. They are kind of synchronized, so we might... It looks a bit weird. So I might add like a different speed for each of these CPUs. Yeah, they have different speeds. Oh, we have to... Look how the ball is infinitely bouncing to the right side. We have to respawn the ball. Yeah, pretty good. So it respawned and it had the animation. I think this is pretty much done. I can't think of another change I want to do right now. Again, you can improve on the gameplay. You could make, like here, another button with mode. And then you can select some kind of difficulty. But since the ball, the speed is increasing, I think this works pretty well right now. So let's close this. And let's close Visual Studio. So now if I click on the executable here, I have the same program, as you can see. Pretty nice. And I can play. And this way you have your executable available at any time. Yeah, so that was a long video, a lot of explanations, but I hope I didn't miss anything important. So definitely check out the Discord, because if you have any questions, then I gladly will answer any questions. And yeah, and if you would like to support my content, then there's also a Patreon. And I think that's it for this video. So thank you for watching and see you for the next game.